So I came to Hamilton like I think a lot of people did, which is that video, Lin-Manuel Miranda in the White House, you know, this young composer, just fresh off his first Broadway hit with In the Heights. You know, he's been invited to do something about the American experience, but no one was expecting what he was gonna do. He got up on stage and he said, I'm gonna perform something. It's a from a hip-hop album, a concept album about someone who I think embodies hip-hop, Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton. And the room laughs. And I laugh too, because it seems kind of unreal. It seems like an SNL sketch in a way. You know, this dead white man, the first Treasury Secretary, rapping on stage. It just seemed like a parody. But then he started performing. And it was so natural. It was so passionate. And the lyrics were so clever that everyone was just silent and in awe. And I was too. When just 5 minutes ago, I was laughing it off as a joke. And everyone laughed. And I laughed too, because it just didn't seem real. It seemed like an SNL sketch, right? These dead white men, founding fathers, Treasury Secretary, rapping on stage. It just didn't seem real. And then he started. And like everyone else, I was quiet. And it just seemed like, why hasn't this been done before? You know, it just seems so natural. This guy, coming from nothing, dropped in the middle of nowhere, worked his way to become a general for Washington in the Revolutionary War, became Treasury Secretary of the United States, the very first one, very first cabinet member in Washington's office. And hip-hop and rap was just the perfect language to express his drive. And it just seemed so natural when 5 minutes ago I was just laughing it off. So I feel like that's a microcosm of the experience of people's... is a microcosm of the way people experience Hamilton, which is it starts with disbelief. It goes to, oh, this is actually pretty good. And then I cannot believe this is happening and I'm crying over Alexander Hamilton. Okay, so that was it for about a year. I watched that video and I was excited for it. I thought this is going to be interesting, but it seemed like the kind of idea that would just fall away and just exist as one YouTube video, which I was very happy with. But then a year went past, buzz picked up, and all of a sudden it was nominated for, 16 Tonys, won 11, and matched the all-time Tony record for one show. It's become like the biggest hit on Broadway, the biggest thing that bigger than Lin had actually imagined. He always said that he thought In the Heights was going to be his biggest show. Well, he didn't know what big was until Hamilton came along. What I like about it is how complicated it is. You know, on the one hand, on the surface, the most noticeable and sort of publicity-worthy thing is the rapping, the fact that cabinet battles are represented as rap battles and stuff, and that's really cool. I love that stuff. I love bars. I like Hamilton dropping bars. But also, it's at its core, it's such an emotional story about, you know, this one dude who came from nothing and is achieving everything, and he's just going for it. And then on the opposite side, the antagonist of the story, who is an antagonist, but we relate to him so much. He's Aaron Burr. He's the guy that shot Hamilton in that fateful duel. And you don't just relate to Hamilton's drive and wanting to achieve everything, but you also relate to Burr's cautiousness and the fact that he's been through so much but is willing to wait for his success, who's able to... Okay, I think the song that has resonated with me more than most of the other songs is a song called Wait For It. So it's Aaron Burr's big I Want song. It's what... It's Burr expressing what he feels and his philosophy in life. And it starts off with him talking about his parents, talking about how they died at a young age. And so many of his experiences line up with Hamilton exactly, you know. And they even go to the same college. But the song also expresses how they diverge in a way that he's wondering how Hamilton is able to just keep going for every opportunity he sees, just keep going forward. And Burr seems to be standing still, waiting for the perfect opportunity. And the song is not just a reinforcement of his belief, he's also questioning his entire life philosophy and wondering, am I doing the right thing by waiting for my opportunities? And the entire show sort of circles around the relationship between those two characters until the very end of the show, when one kills the other and they suddenly switch roles, where Burr is the one seizing his opportunity, taking his shot and shooting Hamilton, whereas Hamilton uncharacteristically sort of holds back and loses his life in the process. I think Hamilton, it has shown that it has drawn people from a lot of different backgrounds. I mean, people are going to see the show from ages like 7 to 70, you know. It is known to be drawing the most diverse crowd that Broadway has ever seen. You know, celebrities, people you wouldn't see in a theatre, Madonna, Beyonce, they've all been there, President Obama, and all sorts of people from the political sphere, but also celebrities, and everyone in between. Students have been getting to see it for $10 a piece if their schools are chosen to come see it. I think what it does so well, it goes beyond what you think a musical would be. Its music goes beyond what you would expect of hip-hop. I think everyone is relating to the themes at the center of it, which are so universal, which are, you know, what am I going to leave behind? What am I living for? And, you know, love and acceptance and your reputation, you know. So, and I think the music is just a way of expressing that in a very, albeit catchy way. But I think people are relating to that first and foremost, and the really well drawn out characters from history